Last time we have discussed the before that last time we started with the design graphical method for absorber. So our stripper we can use for both, mean at the same time we were carrying both of the main equipment, either absorber or the stripper in parallel. So yesterday I told you that initially when you have to use this method, that is the graphical method. So in that graphical method, actually you are using equilibrium as well as operating lines. So in the last lecture, we have discussed that how we can draw those equilibrium and operating lines, and we studied some of the equations with the help of those. I mean, these operating line as well as equilibrium line can be drawn. So in the last part up to there we have discussed, and the next part is actually the calculation of the absorbent flow rate as well the number of stages. These both actually run in parallel. So I'm just starting with the minimum absorbent flow rate. At the same time, when you have drawn, for example, in this figure, you can see that there are number of operating line as well equilibrium line. I will just explain it. So when you have drawn equilibrium line and operating line, then you can just also calculate the number of trays that we will just calculate in next step. Before that, here I will talk about the minimum absorbent flow rate. Actually, in absorption, when we are bringing the liquid inside the system, which is used as a absorbent media, its amount can be varied. Liquid flow rate can be varied. For example, here in this diagram, you have seen that on the x-axis there is X capital, and X capital, you know that moles of solute divided by, they were the moles of solute free liquid, as well at the top there is the moles of solute per that is Y capital, and that was divided by mole of solute divided by mole of solute free gas. This was discussed yesterday, what is X and Y. And at the same time, I also told you that this is the ratio of actually, as well you can call it ratio between the mole fraction of the solute to the mole fraction of solute free gas, and similar for the liquid. So on this x and y axis you draw this equilibrium line as well operating line. So in this diagram, equilibrium line for one system is the one equilibrium line that is shown, but the operating lines are more than one. Here four operating lines are actually shown. And what is difference between these operating lines? The difference is that in all of these here, what we are doing, we are just keeping the V prime constant. If you remember, there was one equation for drawing the operating lines, and in those operating line, I told you yesterday that slope of the line was equal to L prime over V prime. So slope of this line, now let's look at this, that there are four operating lines. So what is difference between their slope? If you look, if you start from the line one, then move toward line two, three, and four, the slope of the line is decreasing because here slope was equal to L prime over V prime, and we have considered the case that vapor flow rate or V prime remain the same, while at the top, like liquid flow rate, numerator of the equation L prime over V prime, so liquid flow rate is actually increased from 4 towards 1. If we keep on increasing the liquid flow rate, here there is a minimum absorbent flow rate as mentioned, so you then keep on increasing and then reach to the maximum amount of the liquid flow rate. So when we will increase the liquid flow rate, definitely that value will increase and slope of the line will increase. So in any case, when we want to separate something, we want to just remove any component from the gas, so there is always need of some minimum absorbent flow rate. If flow rate is below, then that required absorption cannot be achieved. So in order to achieve always the absorption which we need, there should be some minimum flow rate. So here we will look relationship between the like minimum flow rate and the number of stages, are if we increase the flow rate to the maximum, so then how many number of stages are required. So as you can see here in this diagram, one more point, like just look at this point y1, and y1 point is actually top of the column. If you again remember that diagram, which I mean repeated last time, meaning the last lecture many times. For example, this was your column, absorption column, and it is numbered 1 at the top and there was N at the bottom. So gas that was leaving from here at the top, that was called as having mean vapor, solute fraction as a 1. And its flow rate was like V prime, and anything was entering to this was called as solute having X naught. And similarly, you know that from here vapor will be entering, that will be yn plus 1, and liquid will be leaving, so that will be xn. So this is like top of the column where it is mentioned y1. This point is actually y1 comma x0, this point where like this is leaving from the top. And the other term, because this is one terminal, yesterday we called it top terminal and this is the bottom terminal. So at the bottom terminal, there will be a point, for example, yn plus 1 and xn for the liquid. So like this. So these are the two points at the top of the column and this is at the bottom of the column. So they are just connected. With the help of that, we actually draw the operating line. So this as well from here, it is like yn plus 1 and there will be value of xn and for all of that similar way. So in all of these line, if you look, they all are passing to the y1, this point, and I mean that is the exiting gas concentration, and it passes through the terminal point, that was terminal point is y1 comma x0. As we are looking for some specific separation, so all will be passing from here, but I mean to get this desired concentration of y1, mean desired concentration mean as you know that it is ratio between the moles of solute to the mole of the solute free gas. So in order to achieve some specific value of y1, which is actually constant in any of these cases, it is same either you are using mean any low slope line or the high slope line. Low slope line mean with the minimum absorbent flow rate or then with increased flow rate, always you are achieving that point. In any case, you are just all lining or joining here. Mean in any case, you are achieving desired or the required mean concentration of or amount of the solute, mean that maximum which you want to remove that has been removed, and the specific small amount will be left over. So but the thing is that when will you keep on increasing the flow rate, number of stages will decrease. Later on in next step, we will draw the number of stages and you will look at that again. I mean, just keep this point in mind that when you have to draw the stages, the lowest number of stages are required in this case, and highest number of stages will be required in this case where you will have minimum absorbent flow rate. So far, any flow rate which you are bringing here, mean from the top, so when it is leaving at the bottom, so concentration of solute in the exit liquid here, whatever it has absorbed, the concentration of the solute in the liquid, it depends on the like liquid flow rate. So for example, if we increase the liquid flow rate, in that case, for increased liquid flow rate, more absorption will take place, more components will be there, if we keep just stages constant kindly. So in that case, if there is more flow rate, definitely it will absorb more solute. But as compared to this, if it is less amount passing through this, keeping the stages same, if we don't change the stages, so in that case, then it will absorb less amount of the liquid. So here, because we are saying that amount of the solute it will be leaving with the liquid as it depends on like its flow rate, so we have to find that flow rate, that how much should be flow rate or what is the minimum value of flow rate to achieve some desired concentration. So for that, if we look at this solute balance on the whole equipment. So in that case, you can see yesterday we applied the balance on some part of the equipment. So here it is now solute balance on the complete equipment, that input is equal to output of the solute inside the system. So for input, here it is entering from the top, it will be x naught multiplied by L prime. Yesterday I explained that this is x naught multiplied by L prime, that indicates amount of the solute entering with the liquid. And here, it is entering from the bottom, that will be V prime multiplied by Y n plus 1. That is entering from the bottom. These two are inlet streams, and then there are two outlet streams. So their values, X and L prime from the bottom of the column in the form of liquid, and in the form of vapor at the top, Y1 V prime. So if you just rearrange this equation, you will get the liquid flow rate, equation in terms of these concentration terms as well the vapor flow rate. But if we want to look for this, is if we get simple equation for the liquid flow rate, if we are looking for some desired concentration and whatever that concentration is. But our concern here is to find minimum absorbent flow rate, and then we will link this with some actual flow rate. So minimum absorbent flow rate, that is the mean flow rate that corresponds to the value of xn in equilibrium with yn plus 1. Mean xn is the concentration of the liquid at the nth plate, and when it is coming in contact with the fresh feed or the mean vapor feed that contains concentration of solute as yn plus 1. So solute concentration in the feed gas. It is dependent on that minimum liquid flow rate, which we have to decide that it should be that sufficient, that at the end of the day that liquid can bring this vapor or those solute which are present in the feed gas or the vapor, as well the solute which is present in the liquid stream, they can come in contact with each other and can reach to the equilibrium. So that relation, because we are saying that they should come in contact with each other and should reach to the equilibrium, so that relation can be derived in terms of the K value, because that indicates the equilibrium. So here the same equation, by using the solute balance, you can start with the liquid flow rate, and for liquid flow rate, this is our equation which we have written on the last slide by applying the solute balance, rearranged it in form of liquid. But here, in order to calculate minimum absorbent flow rate, let's introduce the K value. So for K value, if you remember from yesterday, that for equilibrium on the plates here, whatever is coming in contact, liquid and vapor. So here, for this case, the K was equal to Y over X, and then we wrote that what is Y? Y was equal to Y capital over 1 plus Y, and divided by X over 1 plus X. I also derived yesterday or shown you the steps that how K, which was equal to simple Y over X, vapor mole fraction over liquid mole fraction, then how that does that convert it to this such kind of relationship. So we wrote there K was equal to Y over 1 plus Y divided by X over 1 plus X. So here, because the things which are coming in equilibrium with each other, they are the vapor feed solute that is entering from N plus 1 plate just after N, and the liquid which is leaving from the nth plate, they will come in equilibrium with each other. So due to this, we have put here Yn plus 1 and Xn. So when we have to find the minimum liquid flow rate, in order to find minimum liquid flow rate by using this equation which is shown at the top, we have to replace some of the parameter in that, and that parameter replaced is Xn, which we will get from this equation. So the purpose here is to just rearrange this equation of the equilibrium of K value, and we have to rearrange it in such a way that we can get the value of xn, and when we will get the value of xn, we will put it in this equation, and then equation will be actually providing us the minimum liquid flow rate for that equilibrium condition to be achieved. So I have just rearranged this equation. We'll take this denominator part to the other side of equation, and you will get this equation xn kn over 1 plus xn is equal to the other part of the equation will remain, say only the numerator. And then just cross multiply these equation, this equation. I will just cross multiply both of the sides, and we'll try to reach some conclusion for xn. So just simplify this equation, do some addition, subtraction, rearrangement of the equation, and then finally we get a relationship in this equation 3, which is the relationship for xn, which we were looking for to be put in the equation of the liquid. So that was equation 1. So when you will get this equation rearranged, you can put it in that equation. So here you can see that this is yn plus 1 divided by kn plus kn into yn plus 1 minus yn plus 1. So you can even take sum of the variable as a common. So here either we can take kn as a common and can just simplify equation a bit. And then if I put it in this equation here for the liquid, so it will be v prime multiplied by this factor, and I will just replace this xn with the value which I have just got after rearranging the equation. So then equation will be converted to the minimum liquid flow rate at the equilibrium condition. So just instead of xn, this part is replaced, which was derived here, minus x naught. And just let's simplify this equation further. So if we consider that our system has dilute or very small amount of the solute inside the system, like entering inside the system, if it is in very small amount as compared to the other flow rate, for example solute, because will be contributed from the gas that is coming inside the system. Let's consider its amount is negligible, or those components if we want to remove, they are negligible or in very small amount as compared to the other mainstream of the gas. So in that case, you know that y capital was equal to y small over 1 minus y small. What was this? This y is mole fraction of the solute divided by that was mole fraction of the solute free gas. So when this is very dilute, so actually this equation is y over 1 plus y. Very dilute mean mole fraction of this solute inside the gas is in very small amount. So when this value y small is very small, negligible, so will it make any difference in the denominator? No, it will be more or less 1 in the denominator. So in that case, we have just taken it that y capital will be equal to then y small divided by when it will be 1, so it is equal to simple y small. And similarly for the x, because it is also x over 1 minus x, and if this value is very small, mole fraction of the solute inside the liquid, because that is coming from the gas, when it is very small amount in the gas, definitely will be small amount inside the liquid. So it will be x small over 1 minus x, so that is also simply x small over 1. So here you can replace in this equation actually the terms which are y and capital and x capital with simple mole fraction of the solute inside the gas as well mole fraction of the solute inside the liquid. So if I replace that, v prime will remain same, and this is y and capital plus 1, so y everywhere will be replaced with y small. N plus 1 minus there is y1. Okay, so here then it is yn plus 1 divided by overall this factor is kn plus y small n plus 1 into kn minus 1. As we said that this term, y term, if it is negligible, it is smaller one, then actually the value of this factor, which is yn plus 1 multiplied by kn minus 1, because this is very small value, so overall it will just make this factor small or negligible as compared to the value of kn. Due to this, when we wrote this part, we just wrote yn plus 1, mean this numerator part, in the denominator, only k n we have mentioned here, because the other part of the equation, which is y n plus 1, its value, if we just calculate the value of this factor as compared to k n, because this will be negligible, due to this we have just ignored this equation. Here actually we are trying to simplify this big equation to find the minimum liquid flow rate so that we can bring it as concise equation as possible. So this will be simple, yn plus 1 then divided by kn, this part is neglected, minus x naught. So in the next part, for example, another assumption which we can take, that most of the time we consider that entering liquid that is solute free, or the mole fraction or amount of the solute available in the liquid is, ideally it should be totally free of that, but when you are using in the industrial scale column where this is regenerated and liquid is coming back to the system, it will definitely contain very small amount of the solute, but that's negligible, smaller one. So we can say just initial amount of the solute entering with the solvent inside the system from the top, if that is negligible, almost approximately equal to the zero, so then that equation will be further simplified here. It will be like v prime y n plus 1 minus y 1 divided by this y n plus 1 over k n, because now this x naught is also negligible, that can be ignored. So your equation is left over in this part except x naught. So we have just rearranged this in such a way that this k n, which is denominator of the denominator, will jump to the numerator. So I have written here, rearrange the equation, v prime k n multiplied by y n plus 1 minus y 1 over y n plus 1. Other part of the equation remains same like this. So then this is now your final expression to find the minimum liquid flow rate. But what is this term actually? So here liquid minimum flow rate is equal to v prime k n multiplied by this amount, y n plus 1 is the amount of solute entering from the bottom of the column, minus this is y 1 amount of the solute, or sorry, mole fraction of the solute leaving from the top of the column. So overall, for example, if this value is initially for example, we say that it is 0.1, like it is 10% or in mole fraction, if it is 0.1 and at the end it remains only 0.01, mean if it's 9% is removed, so divided by this will be 0.1. As I am taking this as a 0.1 minus, then at the top if it is 0.001 at the top here. So in that case, if you just calculate it divided by then 0.1, this is the mean mole fraction at the entrance of the column. So you can see that this is actually giving you the fraction of the solute absorbed, fraction of the solute absorbed, how much solute has absorbed, its fraction actually. So this, due to this written here, fraction of the solute absorbed, here in this case it will be 90%, that example which I have given to you. Otherwise, for example, when later we will solve the problem, in that, in I think he mentioned that 90% of the solute is absorbed, so that then we will take it as a 0.97 in the form of fraction. So this equation here is the for finding the liquid minimum flow rate. So this equation, as mentioned here, indicates that for specific operation means to achieve some desired separation, so minimum liquid flow rate that will increase if you increase the V prime K, or the main solute which you want to absorb. If you want to absorb more solute, definitely you will need more liquid flow rate as well, like to vapor flow rate or the peak value of K. So this is equation for the minimum liquid flow rate. When we have in that case, then definitely when we bring the minimum liquid flow rate, the maximum number of stages will be required to achieve that separation. But in practice, actually we don't bring in the column minimum liquid flow rate, that liquid flow rate which we will call it like actual flow rate. So actual flow rate is like 1.1 times up to 2 times of minimum liquid flow rate. Why? Because we want to decrease the number of trays. So when you will just increase the liquid flow rate, as we have seen the one diagram earlier, that was four cases, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in those cases, if you look that there was change in the slope of the operating line, and I told you that when there will be the liquid minimum flow rate, in that case you need maximum number of plates, which was case four. And in case one, which was totally vertical line, which was having the maximum slope, in that case you will need minimum number of plates because you are bringing maximum liquid flow rate. So overall, if you increase the one, the other will definitely decrease. If you keep on increasing the liquid flow rate, number of trays will decrease. So there is a trade-off. When we have to select, we don't make it like maximum liquid flow rate to keep them stages minimum, or in order to we don't keep minimum flow rate to keep the stages as a maximum. So always there is a trade-off. You will bring the liquid in more than the minimum flow rate so that you can reduce the number of stages up to some sufficient limit. So similarly, as we have drawn this equation, or we have derived, sorry, this equation for absorber, one equation can be derived for the stripper by following the same steps. So in that case, we will get final relationship as a minimum flow rate of stripping. Here it is minimum flow rate of the liquid or the absorbent, and in case of stripping, there is a stripping agent. So minimum flow rate of the stripping gas or stripping as this stripping agent, that will be equal to this equation. Then it will depend on the liquid flow rate and K value and the fraction of the solute which you want to strip from the system. So if you are interested, I will advise you, it will be better if you just derive this equation in the similar way as we have done this. So I think final relationship was given for this, and in between one or two equation in the book, but you can go through the whole steps and same steps which we have done for absorber, and you can read to the stripping equation. Initially, when you will start with the equation, here we were looking for the liquid flow rate. You will rearrange the equation in such a way that it will be giving you the vapor flow rate. So it will be V prime and something, and then just rearrange the equation, and here definitely you have to put the value of Y, because for that case we are looking for the stripping. So instead of X, you will be considering the Y, and think it will be going with the gas at the top of the column. So you will reach to the same conclusion which is mentioned here. So whenever you have to design the system, you have to find the liquid flow rate. So liquid flow rate initially calculated will be the minimum liquid flow rate, and then you can keep it any factor in between this range 1.1 to 2, and you will get the actual liquid flow rate. So when we have that, then we can draw the actual operating line and the equilibrium line, and the next step is to calculate the number of stages. So in order to calculate number of stages, as you can see here in the diagram, when we have actually drawn equilibrium line and the operating line, to draw the number of stages, this is by the way for the absorber, because your operating line is above the equilibrium line. So in that case, you will just start from the point which is Y1 X naught. Always we have to start with that point, either it is stripper or the absorber. So, and we draw a line which reaches to the equilibrium line. So in that case, we have to draw the horizontal line starting from this point, which is Y1 comma X naught. From the operating line, always we have to start from here, and if we draw the some horizontal line, we will reach to the equilibrium line, and then you have to draw a line again from equilibrium to the operating line, and that will be a vertical line. In first case horizontal line, then vertical line, and then again from here, if still some area is left over, if you didn't reach to the top of the column, so top of the line, so here again, and then we will make, so, and then the last one here, and that's it. Up to 3 it will be. If I just draw any other line, I will just cross this, and that is not needed, because then you will be going beyond equilibrium. So up to here there will be number of trays, how you have to draw. These are the three like number of trades. So similar is mentioned here that how you have to draw the operating number of stages when you have drawn operating line and equilibrium line. So you have to start with this point always y1 comma x0. That is actually top of the column, or here we can say at the bottom of the curve, operating line. So horizontal move is made initially to the right to keep or reach the equilibrium, and then you just move to the top to reach to the again operating line, and so on. You will keep on just repeating these steps, and number of trades you will calculate. Keep moving in the similar fashion, and finally up to where you have to reach this point, final point, which is yn plus 1 comma xn. If you look this point on the actually that line, that is yn plus 1 comma xn. So up to that point we have to draw the line. So sometimes you will draw the lines and another point here, I will just come back to that point which I was going to talk about. So how you have to count the stages. So stages can be counted. The easy way is to count the number of points on the equilibrium line. For example, here if you are confused how many number of stages are, just look at the points. Here you can see that there are 3 points on the equilibrium line. So when you were drawing the lines, at the 3 points you cut the equilibrium line. So in that case you can say here there are 3. So sometime when you draw the lines, and if they are not like a whole number, for example if you draw and after 3 there is a half line, or in that case, if whatever is the case, like you are just above a number but it is not complete, so you can round off to the next number. Like if it is for example 3.5, so we will write there will be needed are the 4 plates. It will not be like 3.5 or 3.25 and like that. I will just come back to that last slide. This is for stripper. In the last diagram we discussed that how to draw the lines on a observer. In case of stripper, again here you will draw the equilibrium line and the operating line, and in this case we discussed this yesterday that equilibrium line will be at the top and operating line is at the bottom. So again, to start with that, to draw the lines, you have to start from the same point, which is y0 comma x, inside this it is opposite, because for stripper you know that it is numbered from bottom to the top. So here you have to take from where stripping agent is entering, and that point is y0 comma x1. In case of absorber, we start from the top, and that is like x0 comma y1, but here that is y0 comma x1 point. But that is located on the operating line. You have to start from this point. Now here equilibrium line is at the top of the operating line. So first move will be in the vertical side instead of horizontal, as in it was the case of absorber. But here it is a stripper. In this case, you have to reach to the equilibrium line by drawing the vertical line starting from your first point, which is y0 comma x1 on the operating line. And then when you have reached to the equilibrium line, similar motion in how you will draw the horizontal line and reach to the operating line, and then this again vertical, horizontal line, then vertical line, then horizontal line, and you will reach to the point, final point, which is like xn plus 1 comma yn. There you have to just stop drawing the lines. So this is how you have to then draw the line and count. Again here there will be the 3 stages. Actually there are the 3 points, like here 1, 2, and 3. This is just the not point, because when we started from here. This is first point here finally, and then there is like next point and then next point. So there are 3 stages inside this system, involved inside this system. So in this diagram here, when you look at this is a similar diagram from where we started, when we started the calculation of minimum liquid flow rate. So you can see that there are number of lines, and I already told you that in these lines what is the difference. We just keep vapor flow rate as the same, but we have increased the liquid flow rate starting from this 4 and moving towards the 1. So a slope of the line was changing, but actually increasing. So Here there is a relationship between like slope of the line and the liquid flow rate keep on increasing in such case. So whenever you have to draw the line, for example, now if I just start from here and start drawing the lines in this case, for example, here and we go there and then you like just complete the number of trays in such case. So here and then somewhere like you will reach there and then still here and maybe you will be reaching to this point or close to that, or maybe you need half another plane. But I just want to make comparison. If I just want to draw any for other line, mean for example for line 2, so you will reach to here, then you will just draw the line from that point to the this line and then just draw the line from here, and definitely you are just beyond that point, so your line because has already ended here, that final point xn comma yn plus 1. So in that case you see that there is a one plate and maybe one and a half. But as compared to this, if you look at the first case when I was drawing for the line 4, you can see that we have drawn at least 3 or 4 number of plates. So as you keep on increasing the liquid flow rate, the number of stages will decrease. This was the point here. So for the minimum liquid flow rate, like infinite number of plates are needed. So in that case, the operating line and the equilibrium line will intersect at a pinch point. This point is called pinch point, where actually your equilibrium line and operating line will be intersecting, and this will be possible when you are bringing the minimum absorbent flow rate. And this point is called pinch point, where your main line will just intersect equilibrium line and operating line, and this will be possible only they will intersect when there is a minimum absorbent flow rate. But if it is higher, definitely they will not intersect. The your line, operating line, will be away somewhere from the equilibrium line. So this is all about it. If you have any question up to here, just let me know.
सर जिस तरह यहाँ पे हमने एब्जॉर्बर के लिए किया, तो अगर स्ट्रिपर का केस लिया जाए तो फिर मिनिमम स्ट्रिपर फॉर फ्लो रेट के लिए भी इन क्या नाम है इनफिनिट प्लेट्स होंगी.
यस एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली. सो इन दैट केस इफ यू टेक लाइक मिनिमम एब्जॉर्बेंट सॉरी स्ट्रिपिंग एजेंट फ्लो रेट दैट इज वी प्राइम, सो इन दैट केस यू विल नीड मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ ट्रेज आर वी कॉल इट इनफिनिट नंबर ऑफ ट्रेज टू अचीव दैट मीन stripping or to remove all those components that you want to remove from the liquid. Yes, that will be the same case.
सर ये जो हमने मिनिमम फ्लो रेट की जो इक्वेशन निकाल दी ड्राइव की है.
Yes.
में से जो लिक्विड लीव कर रहा है और जो वेपर जो उस जो प्लेट उससे नीचे है उस पे आ रहा है, ठीक है, वो वाली प्लेट पे, वो इक्विलिब्रियम में होंगे. ये कंडीशन लगा के हम दोनों मिनिमम फ्लो रेट पे.
आप काइंडली रिपीट करो, बीच में आपकी आवाज कट गई थी.
सर मैंने कहा ये जो हम लोग बेसिकली मिनिमम फ्लो रेट की डेरिवेशन की है ना, हम लोगों ने ये हम लोगों ने ये कंडीशन लगाई है कि बेसिकली जो लिक्विड किसी भी प्लेट से लीव कर रहा है और जो वेपर आ रहे हैं नीचे वाली प्लेट से उस प्लेट पे, वो इक्विलिब्रियम में होंगे.
एक्चुअली द सॉल्यूट को इक्विलिब्रियम में आने ना, लिक्विड और वेपर में से क्या चीज जो एक से दूसरे में ट्रांसफर हो रही थी, वो सॉल्यूट. वी हैव कंसीडर्ड दैट कंडीशन. वो जो के है ना, वो सॉल्यूट के लिए, ना कि लिक्विड और वेपर के फ्लो रेट के लिए. एक्चुअली सॉल्यूट है वो इक्विलिब्रियम में आता है. लाइक सॉल्यूट गेट्स ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम वेपर टू द लिक्विड, तो हम उसके इक्विलिब्रियम कंसीडर कर रहे थे जहाँ के जहाँ से स्टार्ट किया था. एनीथिंग एल्स? Otherwise, okay, let's start with the problem. So here, already I think we will be short of time, but I think you don't have any lecture after this. Do you have?
Yes, sir, we have.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir,
we lecture? Have. Today it is Wednesday and I think there shouldn't be lecture.
Sir, actually 8 baje lecture hota tha hamara engineering economics ka, to sir humne 11 baje rakhwaya tha Ramzan ke andar.
Okay, let me quickly then go through this. I have written already the in detail all the main solutions. So if I'll try to quickly go through that, but later kindly just go through the slides and hopefully you will understand each and everything. So in this statement here, this is the main problem from your book in one of the example. So here I have solved it systematically, although it is solved in the book, but that is, he has made it a bit complex. So and you should know that why you are moving for some specific step. So I have just solved it in that way. So kindly, after solving this, then I will advise you guys to just jump towards now problem solving at the end of the main chapter. So in a bio process, molasses is fermented to produce a liquor containing ethyl alcohol. This is about the process in which some ethyl alcohol is being produced. A CO2 rich vapor with a small amount of ethyl alcohol is evolved. This is like the information that there is CO2 rich vapor, that means CO2 in large amount, and that contains small amount of ethyl alcohol is evolved. The alcohol is recovered by absorption with water in a sieve tray tower. The alcohol, which is part of the CO2 stream, so that alcohol we want to just remove with the help of water, determine the number of equilibrium stages required for the counter current flow of the liquid and gas. So here we have to just calculate the number of equilibrium stages, assuming isothermal, isobaric condition and absorption of ethanol only. So here there will be temperature and pressure, I think, are given, so that remains same throughout the column. So here are the condition for the entering gas. Its flow rate is total 180 kmol per hour. There are 98% CO2 and 2% ethyl alcohol, which he said is the small amount. So this is at 30 degrees C and 110 kilopascal. As well, the liquid or the absorbent which you are entering, that is 100% pure water. What does this mean? Will there be any solute in this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So, guys, it is 100% pure liquid. So, that also enter at the same condition. So, required recovery or absorption of ethyl alcohol is 97%. What does this mean? That 97% of ethyl alcohol, which is entering in the system, of that 97% is removed in this absorption column, and still 3% will be leaving at the top. So activity coefficient you will need somewhere, so that is 6 I mentioned here. So I have just drawn a diagram to just give you the idea. I have labeled all the things here. Vapor enter are the like 180 kmol per hour, and it is 98% CO2, and there is some 2% amount of main C2H5OH. Here there is a mistake, kindly, this is not YN+1. Similarly here, yes, we have to find that Y, but this is not directly, 2% is not YN+1, please ignore this. So there is a liquid which is pure 100% water. Due to this, I mentioned here, X0 will be 0, and from the bottom, that liquid will be leaving water as well. It will contain some amount of C2H5, which we don't have here, or XN, we don't know. So as well, the vapor which are leaving from the top, CO2, that can be calculated, but at the moment we don't know how much it is. As well, amount of C2H5 going to the top, that was 3% of this which was entering, that we can also calculate, but at the moment we don't know. I have just put it as just unknown. But the purpose here, you are advised to determine the number of equilibrium stages. So what we will do, or what is needed to calculate the number of equilibrium stages, can you tell me? This is written here. In order to draw, calculate the number of equilibrium stages, you just saw here that you will need two lines. We call them equilibrium line and the operating line. So, from the last lecture, yesterday we studied this, like what was the value of K. Also, it was used somehow today. So, K was equal to Y small over X small. So, I have just written it the general equation for the linking Y and X in terms of K. I didn't put N or something, but you can put just there while I think number N, like for N place. So here, this is the equation for, we call it, it is for equilibrium. So this equation is for equilibrium. If we have to draw the equilibrium line, we studied that this equation can be used. But here you will need some Y and X and somehow value of K maybe needed, or relationship between Y and X. But okay, let's look that this is one of the equation which you can use to draw the equilibrium line. Let's hold it here. Similarly, like here, okay, I mentioned here you will need K value so that you can develop a relationship between X and Y. You can rearrange this equation in such a way, if we have K, and there will be a relationship between x and y, and if we know any of that, for example, either x or y, then we can calculate other variable. So let's move forward. The next is to draw the operating line, and for drawing the operating line of the absorber, this was the equation which was derived yesterday. So that was y n plus 1 is x n minus x naught into liquid flow rate solute free over volume, vapor flow rate solute free plus y 1. And if we use this equation, in this equation you can see that we need a lot of information: liquid flow rate, vapor flow rate, like y1, x0. Somehow then you can rearrange the equation in such a way that you can link this yn plus 1 and xn to draw the operating line. So now up to here, you know what is the purpose. The purpose is to, in order to calculate the number of trades, number of stages, you need equilibrium and operating line, and for those we have the equation, but information is missing for you use of those equation. So by using the given information as it was given in the question, I have calculated few of those things here, like V prime. What is V prime?
Volumetric flow rate of solute free gas.
Yes, and what is that? That is CO2, because here if you look, the gas entering contain two components, CO2 and ethyl alcohol. So out of that, I mean, if I just kick out this C2H5OH, remove it, other is solute free gas. This is solute because how it is solute, because it was mentioned like this is the component which we want to absorb that is undesired in this stream of CO2. So then except this CO2, anything else will be considered as solute free gas, and that is 98% CO2, and that is 98% of 180 overall flow rate, mole fraction into its total number of mole, it will give you this value. Similarly, C2H5OH entering, that will be 2% of 180, its value is calculated. And if you remember, he mentioned that C2H5, its recovery is 97%. That means 97% of the ethyl alcohol which is entering to the system will be absorbed. 0.97 of 3.6. This was calculated. And also, we know from as there was 100% water was entering, so X naught is equal to 0. These are the few things which I have just done or calculated based on the given data. But still it has solved some of the problem, V primes, X naught, but still many are missing. But at the same time, we have found some values of ethyl alcohol, like entering, absorbed or leaving. So at the same time, you can also calculate that how much C2H5OH will be leaving from the top of the column. From here, 3.6 moles are entering, and out of those, mean 97% of that goes to this stream. It is 97% of this stream, and here it is 3% of that. So that we have calculated that 3.492 will be absorbed, and this will be still leaving at the top with the CO2 stream. It will not be absorbed. That is 3% of 3.6. So I've just taken the difference of these two, and it will give me the value. So we need here actually y1, yn plus 1, and xn, these things to proceed. So let's try to find those. But out of those, maybe we can easily find y1, yn plus 1, but xn we can't find at the moment. For that, later on I will tell you that you need liquid flow rate actually, because you know x. What is x? X is equal to moles of the solute divided by moles of solute free solvent. The simple equation, this n is the nth position, or the mean, it will be at the bottom of the column. So we need actually liquid flow rate for this specific value. So we have calculated the liquid flow rate initially, and that we will start with minimum flow rate equation somewhere, that liquid flow rate, minimum liquid flow rate is V prime K. We just derived this equation today. So V prime K multiple by fraction of the solute absorbed. And when we will find the minimum liquid flow rate, then I said, some fraction of the minimum, not fraction actually, it is some factor. So the minimum liquid flow rate is treated as an actual flow rate. we mentioned that it is like 1.1 times to 2 times. You can take any value in between that. That will be treated as a actual liquid. So here to find the minimum flow rate, you need actually K value of vapor flow rate. We know because you can already given V prime in the question. So fraction, you know that 97% is absorbed. So K value for this ethanol can be calculated by using modified Raoult's law, modified because its value is very small, negligible, or this is dilute system actually. Due to this, we are using this. Gamma P set over P. Now you need gamma, which was activity coefficient, and P set, which can be found from the literature related to ethanol at the given condition 30 degree C and 110. Here I've directly taken it from the book, but you can look at the ethanol data and these you can find at these conditions. I think at the end of the book, this data is available, or in chapter 2, you can check. So K value we have find from here, we will put it and you will get minimum liquid flow rate. After that, as you know that mean actual flow rate is 1.1 to the 2 time of the minimum flow rate. So here I have taken 2 time of the mean liquid flow rate, minimum flow rate. So that will be calculated L prime. When you have this, then you can find the values now required for that X naught, Y1, as well Xn and Yn plus 1. You know that X naught is 0, Y1, that is moles of C2H5 leaving from the top divided by moles of CO2. When at the start, I think Adnan asked this question, that value remains same. We are considering here that it remains same at the anything which enters from the bottom, that will be leaving same from the top. In this case here, while solving the problem, but in reality, definitely this will not be case. Some amount of this will be absorbed inside the liquid. So, but here, okay, it is 176.4, you can calculate Y1. Similarly, Xn, moles of C2H5OH leaving from the bottom divided by in the liquid stream. And this is mole of the liquid. Already studied these formulas yesterday, so just you can use that. And moles of C2H5, you know that was 97% of the ethanol which was entering, that was absorbed. So that amount is this divided by the flow rate of the liquid, which we just calculated. So for Yn plus 1, C2H5 entering divided by C2. Just a minute, we are just about to finish. So these are the value you will get. And here you can see that actually X is varying, X naught to Xn. You know that X is varying from 0 to 0.018. So now I think we have all of the values. You can draw the line somehow, but operating line you can draw, but for equilibrium line we will go back to that equation, that was K is equal to Y over 1 plus Y over X over 1 plus X. So if you just rearrange that equation in such a way that we can develop the relationship between X and Y, so K value already calculated. I have just done this simple mathematics to rearrange the equation. So finally I got this equation, which was linking Y with the X. So as you have seen with the data that X was varying from 0 to 0.018. So just kindly make some intervals so that you can get number of points to draw the good line, for example. So I have taken it like here, 6 interval. I varied it with the difference of 0.003. You can take even less than that, you can get more points. So then put the value of X here and you will get Y for each of these points. When you will get X and Y, you can go to that diagram. There was X and Y. Take each of the pair and like then you can draw some line. That will be equilibrium line. And for operating line, you have to draw a straight line that pass through these points, which are actually your terminal points. They are like here, it will be something X naught and Y1, and then there will be the point at the top, X and Y n plus 1, as you have just seen in the last few diagrams in the lecture. So that will be some straight line just passing through these points. You can even extend it beyond that, but when you have to draw the stages, your first point, starting point will be this, like this one, and then final point will be where there is X and Y n plus 1. And that's it, we are done. So guys, I have quickly explained it already, recording is also there. Still, if you don't get any point, you can ask me. So. Just thank you so much, and you can leave. I will quickly again discuss this tomorrow in the start if you will have any questions. So you can leave and just join next class. Thank you so much. But if someone has any question, they can stay here.